Her personal music folio includes many annotations and markings in Dickinson's own handwriting in both pencil and pen. From these markings, it is clear that she possessed a secure knowledge of the physical and analytical knowledge required to prepare a piano score in readiness for performance. Issues pertaining to hand position, note accuracy, and perhaps more poignantly, fingering markings, track an intimate yet critical visceral journey. When a pianist initially engages with a piece of music, one of the first things they must do, once notes have been identified, is strategically determine a comfortable and accessible fingering pattern. Correct fingering acts as a metaphoric key that, once applied, neatly and swiftly opens the locked door. Piano fingering is a bespoke mechanism in an individual's performance preparation. The performer's physiology and level of pianistic development inform the choices made. So in this example, from her music folio, I've included what was most common practice, which is printed fingering markings, as opposed to her own annotations. So most of the music in her music folio had printed annotations. This is very difficult to see, but this is an example of Emily Dickinson's annotations in the bass clef, where she was writing in note names. And this is common practice for pianists at various stages of development, particularly when working in extension areas, such as notes above or below the stave, written on ledger lines. And you can see here that she's writing in the ledger lines, which are the small notes written with a tiny line through them in the bass clef, exactly. Thank you. Next. The fingering method that Emily Dickinson was using was called the English fingering system, which was used between 1800 and 1950, roughly, which used the system where thumb was marked as an X or a cross, and the index, middle ring and pinky fingers were 1, 2, 3, and 4. So there was no fifth finger in the English fingering system.